There is no need to recycle the same sidebar structure for all your content, particularly when WordPress offers plenty of alternatives. Creating a custom sidebar can enable you to shake up your site's design and unique elements depending on which page your users are browsing. Hi, my name is Robert from Themeisle.com. For this tutorial, we'll be using the Custom Sidebars WordPress plugin. This simple tool enables you to replace your core WordPress sidebar with more customizable options. With it, you'll be able to create multiple new sidebars and assign them to specific pages, post types, and categories, among other options. Naturally, there are plenty of other tools for creating custom sidebars in WordPress, but few are as intuitive as this one. In fact, I can teach you how to use it in just 2 steps. Before we jump in, remember to install and activate the plugin first. Once the plugin is up and running, you'll find an option that reads "Create a new sidebar" under Appearance, Widgets on your dashboard. Click on it and you'll be able to choose a name and a description for your custom sidebar. If you plan on setting up more than one sidebar, remember to pick a descriptive name so you'll be able to remember which sidebar is which. Your new addition will appear under the Custom Sidebars section. Now, all you have to do is drag and drop the elements you want from the available widgets column to your new sidebar. For example, we created a custom sidebar named Archives Sidebar and dragged both an Archives and a Recent Post widgets into it. If you've ever customized a regular WordPress sidebar, you'll feel right at home. The real difference lies in step number 2. It's worth noting that Custom Sidebars doesn't add any new widgets options to WordPress. If you want to try out new elements, you'll need to explore other options. When you create a new custom sidebar, it won't appear on your frontend until you tell the plugin where it should go. To do this, return to the Custom Sidebar section under Appearance, Widgets. Find the sidebar you want to add to your site and click on Sidebar Location. On the following screen, you'll get the chance to choose from an extensive list of criteria, including sidebar and footer options. For example, selecting the As Sidebar for Selected Categories option will enable you to choose the categories you want the sidebar to appear on. After selecting your criteria, remember to save your changes, and you'll be all set. On the other hand, if you want to add a custom sidebar to a specific post or page, you'll need to edit that specific page. When the plugin is enabled, a new sidebars widget will appear in the WordPress editor for your new and existing posts. All you need to do here is pick the custom sidebars you want for the locations that are available. If you want to use a single option, just leave the rest blank, and WordPress will go with your default settings instead. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe, then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.